The universe is still an unexplored place for humanity, with many mysteries. Today, we will talk about one of them. Are we alone in space? If not, where is everyone? This phenomenon is called the Fermi Paradox. So, let's start by delving into the heart of the matter. The Fermi Paradox, named after the brilliant physicist Enrico Fermi, is the apparent contradiction between the high probability of extraterrestrial civilizations in the vast universe and the lack of any contact or evidence so far. Enrico Fermi was known for his wit and cleverness, and one day, while having lunch with some colleagues, he casually remarked, "Where is everybody?" This simple question formed the basis of the Fermi Paradox. If there are so many potential alien civilizations out there, why haven't we encountered them yet? Picture the universe as a vast cosmic playground with billions of galaxies, each containing billions of stars, many of which have their own planets. The approximate number of planets in the known universe is 70 trillion. That is 7 and 22 zeros. Now, doesn't it seem statistically likely that some of these planets might harbor intelligent life? Of course, there are various possible explanations for this cosmic conundrum. Let's explore a few of them. Rare Earth Hypothesis. Some scientists propose that Earth is a rare gem in the universe, a perfect combination of conditions that allowed life to flourish. If life-friendly planets are exceptionally scarce, then the lack of contact makes sense. To develop intelligent life, many conditions must be met. Life forms must be capable of reproducing using molecules like DNA and RNA. Simple cells must evolve into more complex cells, and multicellular organisms must also develop. Additionally, sexual reproduction must prevail, and more complex organisms must learn to use tools. Imagine a cosmic dance of countless planets, but only a few hold the right cards for life's emergence. Zoo Hypothesis. This idea suggests that advanced extraterrestrial civilizations are intentionally avoiding contact with us, treating Earth as a protected zoo or a wildlife preserve. They could be observing from afar, letting us develop at our own pace. Just like we protect untouched lands and uncontacted tribes, these advanced beings might be giving us space to grow. Technological barriers. Perhaps we haven't found any signs of alien life because advanced civilizations reach a technological barrier that prevents them from interstellar travel or communication. Crossing the vast distances of space is no easy feat. Perhaps even advanced civilizations find it insurmountable. For example, the speed of light is 299 million meters per second. One light year, which is the distance light travels in 1 year, is about 9.4 trillion kilometers. This means that when we look at the sun, which is about 147 million kilometers away from us, we see it as it appeared 8 minutes ago. That's because it takes 8 minutes for light to travel from the sun to us, so we are essentially looking into the past. This is the reason why we can't see anyone else, and they can't see us. There are plenty of planets that are hundreds of light years away. If there were a powerful telescope on one of these planets, and they looked at Earth, they would see dinosaurs roaming on our planet. The light carrying information about our current state would take millions of years to reach them. Civilizations must be sufficiently advanced to be able to travel through space and visit us. A civilization capable of such feats falls into the third category according to the Kardashev scale. Type 0, planetary civilization. They control the energy and resources of their planet. Humanity is currently at this level. Type 1, solar civilization. They can use energy from their planet and their star. Type 2, stellar civilization. They control the energy of an entire star. Type 3, galactic civilization. They have the ability to receive energy from the whole galaxy. Type 4 and beyond, superintelligence and overbeings. They are capable of manipulating reality and space-time. Great filter. Now, let's explore one of the most haunting hypotheses related to the Fermi Paradox. The Great Filter. Imagine a formidable obstacle that civilizations must face on their path to becoming a spacefaring society. This filter acts like a cosmic gatekeeper, allowing only a select few civilizations to pass through. One potential candidate for the Great Filter is the development of incredibly powerful weapons that could lead to a civilization's self-destruction. Throughout history, we've witnessed the devastating potential of advanced weaponry. Take the invention of nuclear bombs during World War II, for instance. Humanity's entry into the atomic age raised concerns about the potential for self-annihilation. The Great Filter hypothesis forces us to reflect on our own journey as a species. Are we at a critical juncture in our development? Have we already passed the Great Filter, avoiding the self-destructive path that could have ended our story before it began? As we venture further into space and encounter the unknown, we should be mindful of the choices we make and the impact they may have on our future. The Great Filter remains an enigma, and we can't say for sure if it lies ahead or behind us. What's essential is that we remain conscious of the consequences of our actions and strive for a harmonious and sustainable existence on our pale blue dot. If they exist and know about us, what if they are there but are afraid of us or don't want to contact us? Maybe we are not interesting enough for them. Maybe they consider us an underdeveloped civilization. If they are really observing us, they have countless pieces of evidence about human history: colonization, slavery, expansive wars, and all other events that don't portray Earth in the best light. Maybe they intentionally hide from us because they fear what might happen. After all, these are concerns that we should also share. As Stephen Hawking repeatedly emphasized, just look at ourselves to see how intelligent life might develop into something we wouldn't want to meet. Therefore, perhaps we don't live in an empty universe, but in a silent universe where all civilizations hide with concerns about their own destruction. A beautiful cosmic riddle that leaves us with more questions than answers. Remember that our quest for knowledge and exploration has just begun. Who knows? Maybe one day we will receive answers, or perhaps the mystery will endure, making our journey among the stars even more captivating. Either way, the Fermi Paradox remains unexplained. What do you think? Do extraterrestrial civilizations exist? Are they observing us? If you enjoyed this video, I would appreciate it if you give it a like and subscribe, as more videos like this will be created more often. I'll be looking forward to seeing you in the next video.